whatever time of day it is, folks. We're glad you made it out and braved the roads on the way over. My name is Drew Brown. I am the North Bighorn Basin Music Association president, and it is my distinct honor to welcome you to the 2022 Honor Clinic for our high school students. If we could give these kids one more round of applause, they've been putting a lot of The kids have been putting in a ton of work this year. The music that's been picked has been incredible. They've had a good time preparing it, and after listening to the sound check earlier today, it's going to be a very, very good concert. I am going to, first of all, thank Northwest College for allowing us to come and use their facilities. If we could give Northwest College just in general a round of applause. And then, if I could have the music teachers just stand up and be recognized. It takes a lot of effort, and it takes a village to prepare an event like this. So if the music educators could stand up and get them down. We have 14 music educators here today, and it is incredible the amount of work and preparation that has gone into this. I'm going to go ahead and remind you that the exits are here and back there in case of an emergency, and I will now turn the mic over to Carisa French, the Meeteetse music educator.
Thank you so much. It's been such a fun time having our kids work with our great directors the last couple of days. I'll first introduce our fabulous accompanist, Tim Schoessler. Is here in Powell. We're so lucky to have him. He teaches piano lessons. I think he's been playing for our district for 18 years, something like that. Just a fantastic resource to our area, and he loves doing it, which is even better for us. So please help us welcome Tim Schoessler. I'm also pleased to introduce our choir director. She currently teaches at Kelly Walsh High School and has been a music educator for 24 years. She's known for her amazing choirs and her great vocal and choral jazz prowess. She's highly sought out as a clinician, has been in our district as a clinician within the last 5 years, I believe. And an adjudicator, and has presented many times at the Wyoming Music Educators Conference. We always learn so much from her. She served on many of our boards in many positions, and we just love everything we can learn from her. If your students are going on the Wyoming Ambassadors music trip to Europe, she's the choir director for them. Our students have had an amazing experience with her. Please welcome Katrina Rooney and the North Bighorn Basin Music District Honor Choir.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. I was asked to announce the concert pieces for you in our program. We began with a piece by Jacob Narverud, Ad Astra, which literally means to the stars through difficulty. And so many of these students dedicated that song to someone in their lives. We discussed how we come through adversity and difficulties and keep pushing through and come through to the other side, Ad Astra. We're going to follow with a piece from the Magnificat by Bach, and this is Sicut Locutus Est. Trouble the Water. It is arranged by Dan Jackson, and this is something that our kids would tell you is a mashup, like pitch perfect. It's not a pop piece, but literally what they did is they took several melodies from different well-known songs and put them all together. So you'll hear Wade in the Water, I Want to Die Easy, Didn't My Lord Deliver Death. You'll hear all these different melodies, and then they all fit together. We are very fortunate to have some incredibly talented young musicians who will be singing some solos. On this piece, we have from Rocky Mountain, Jacob Bischoff. Cody, we have Noel Graham. From Powell, we have Maddie Black. From Rocky Mountain, Azure D. Burton. And from Powell, Levi Hawley. This is Trouble the Water.
Water, children, wait in the water.
next piece is called Stay Alive, and it's near and dear to me with the Wyoming connection. It was commissioned by the University of Wyoming Collegiate Chorale Choir. They performed this in March of 2020 at the Northwest ACDA Conference in Spokane. I attended that conference, and if you think back, what happened in March of 2020? Yes, we were there performing. Our students were in the ensembles, and kids started texting me, Miss Rooney, they said there's an important meeting. They said that we have to leave now. Everything got shut down that first day that we showed up. They said, you know what? We have all these choirs that flew in, so University of Wyoming had come all the way out, several other choirs. They said, we want you to perform. So they had one last concert before we left, and then when we came home, we went into quarantine, and that was it. So the University of Wyoming Collegiate Chorale performed this song, Stay Alive. It's arranged by Tim Ribner. If you've seen The Secret Life of Walter Mitty with Ben Stiller, and it came out a few years back, this song was written for it. And this piece, Stay Alive, just talks about the rising sun. So we talked about watching the sunrise in Wyoming or on vacation and seeing the colors rise. But it also is a metaphor for, as we said at the beginning, Ad Astra, going to the stars through difficulties. This is coming through on the other side. The light is rising. We have some amazing soloists on this piece and solo groups. From Rocky Mountain, we have Kennedy Minchow. From Cody, Isaac Wood. From Worland, Ellie Baumstark. From Powell, Jade Ilg. From Cody, Katie Brasher. From Cody, Olivia Hatch. From Worland, Josh Yuslava. I hope I said that right. From Cody, Micah Grant. And from Cody, Jace Grant. This is Stay Alive. Before we finish, I would like to say a huge thank you to the teachers who had these kids so well prepared. So thank you so much to Gerry Burton, Michaella Dukart, Eric Quaschnick, Connor Dennis, Rachel Schoessler, Carisa French, Anissa Bree, Emily Asay, Alyssa Pena, and Jackson Chitwood. And a huge thank you, especially to our an amazing accompanist, Mr. Tim Schoessler. Thank you, Tim. And finally, my thank you is to these kids back here who put up with long hours of rehearsals, tried it one more time when I said that was the last time, and then we did it again, and have come so far from yesterday morning when I heard them the first time. These are talented individuals. These are individuals who have really neat spirits, and just I love coming up to this neck of the woods anytime I can to conduct, because these are some incredible musicians and incredible people. So thank you to my students up here on the stage with me. Congratulations. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Stay alive.
There's a rhythm in the rush these days, where the lights don't move and the colors don't fade. Is you empty with nothing but dreams, in a world gone shallow, in a world gone mean. There is a truth and it's on our side. Dawn is coming, open your eyes. Look into the sun as the new days rise.
So, folks, this year we had the luxury of not having a ton of percussion stuff to do during the concert band selection, so we were able to kind of not last minute, but pretty quickly throw together a percussion ensemble and be able to present that as an honor percussion ensemble. One of my favorite things to do is introduce this next person who's been directing the percussion ensemble this year. He is a Cody High School graduate, a Northwest College graduate, a University of Wyoming graduate, and then he decided to go to Nebraska and Arizona State for his master's and doctorate, but we don't hold that against him. One of the best educators I've ever met, and as well as percussionists all the way around, right here in Powell, Wyoming, as the director of bands, Mr. Dr. Zach Paris.
Thank you so much, everybody, for being here. Since I suppose we are the host institution here. So, yeah, once again, I am the director of bands here at Northwest College. So thank you for being here in this wonderful music building. And we're so happy we're able to host this event once again and hopefully for the foreseeable future as well. We love having all of your students here in this building making music. It's a wonderful time. So this first piece, since there's no pieces in your program, this first piece we're going to do is a piece I wrote called Cascade. And how many of you have heard of Japanese taiko drumming? Some. Oh, cool. Okay. So this we're not getting super physical with it because we'd rather not break these nice heads, okay? But it will still be just, hopefully, just as loud. Yeah, hopefully just as loud. We'll try it. And lots of energy here in this piece. So this is a Japanese taiko drumming inspired piece. And you'll hear some improvisation throughout the work as well. But for the most part, we wanted to really just punch you in the face with something loud and drumming. So here is Cascade.
Thank you.
Didn't they do an awesome job? That was awesome. How about another hand for these guys? So when I started writing that piece, I decided, you know what? I want it to be super spacey and weird at the beginning. Okay, and we'll kind of get some unique percussion sounds in there. So you saw from Victoria some bowed crotales over there, right? Bowed percussion is one of my favorite things, awesome sounds. And so I started out by trying to write this cool bell atonal thing, okay, super random. And I was like, this is way too hard now. I was like, I'm just gonna let Henry come up with whatever's at the top of his head. And so that's kind of what that ended up being. So kudos to Henry for some on the spot atonal bell playing as well. How about a hand for Henry? So before we continue on and play one more piece here for you, I do want to just say a quick thank you to our Northwest College music department here that for the last couple days we've kind of shut things down, no classes, and I'm sure our college students were so disappointed about that. And we had all these great high school students in our building getting to rehearse and meet new people, make music together in a new space, and so we're just so happy that we were able to make that happen. So how about a hand for Northwest College to allow all this to happen? We just underwent our accreditation review through the National Association of Schools of Music, and we are one of the few two-year schools in the nation that is accredited by the National Association of Schools of Music, so we're very happy to report that that is still going very, very well and that we have renewed that. And the college at large as well just went through accreditation, so it's been an accreditation kind of year. And from what I heard, the college had no remarks as far as changes or adjustments to curriculum, anything like that, that the college had to do to renew their curriculum and renew their accreditation. So how about a hand for Northwest College on that end as well? So just while I've got the mic and you're listening to me, I also just want to mention that many of our music majors here at Northwest College and non-majors are getting music scholarship money. Most of our music majors are on full tuition music scholarships here at Northwest. We're blessed to have lots of money to be able to get to all of your students. So all those people sitting over here, we've got scholarship money for all of you. You get a scholarship and you get a scholarship. It's that kind of day. So I want to just encourage you. I don't tell students that they should have all their eggs in the Northwest College basket. I encourage people to go visit other schools, go check out other places and have multiple schools. But I do hope that everybody, all of our students that are here performing, as they're getting close to graduation time, they do have Northwest College on their list, because you never know what kind of offers you're going to get and exactly what kind of education we're able to provide here at Northwest College. We're very proud of that. And so I do also want to say that we are happy to be resuming our Yellowstone Summer Music Camp here this next summer. So yes. And all of the scholarships from the last several years that the event has been canceled, we are honoring those scholarships. So if you haven't been able to participate, your child hasn't been able to participate and would like to, this year we are returning to that. So make sure you check in on our website as we're getting closer into the spring semester, and we'll have lots of information there and registration and all of that for you as well. So save the date on that. It's always the Father's Day. That Sunday is always the beginning of the camp. So I can't tell you off the top of my head what day in June that is. But that Father's Day is the beginning of the camp, so make sure you mark your date, your calendar with that one. We're going to play one more piece for you here, very different than the first piece. This is a keyboard percussion ensemble entitled Sweet Dreams, Elizabeth Lee, and this is by Gabe Musella. We've got a number of soloists on this one, and I want to make sure that I'm not saying wrong names and whatnot. That's been known to happen. So we're going to feature Carson Brennan on marimba. We're going to feature also Jace Erickson playing some vibraphone over there for us. Tyson Hoops on marimba as well. And then Ty Miller, who's waiting patiently over there for me to help him move the piano. You're going to hear a lot of piano work from him as well. So here is Sweet Dreams, Elizabeth Lee by Gabe Musella. us just a couple minutes. We got to get all set up for the band. There's a lot of chairs and things that need to get out here, so don't go away.
ladies and gentlemen, I am Wade French. I'm director of bands at Cody High School. Excited to be with you guys today. First of all, thank you. Thank you, thank you. First of all, I would like to reach out to have you guys give Northwest College, Dr. Zach Paris and Northwest College faculty, please give him a big round of applause. Hosting this event is huge. Absolutely huge. We are one of the few districts in the state of Wyoming that has a college that hosts this event for us, and we are incredibly fortunate, very blessed, and very grateful, Zach, and all the faculty. Thank you so much for doing that. Please give another round of applause as well to the choir and the percussion ensemble you just heard. It's amazing what those clinicians can accomplish with amazing students in just 2 days, so we want to thank them for their work. It is a distinct honor for me today to introduce you guys to the honor band as well as to our clinician. Our clinician comes to us originally from Utah, an incredible award-winning band director from the Granite and Davis school districts in Utah, as well as he became a collegiate band director. He taught at Ricks College as well as BYU-Idaho. I was fortunate enough to work under his baton. He was my college band director and an incredible influence on my life and my career. It was been an honor to be able to invite him here and to see this. So I think you'll agree once you've already heard the choir and the percussion ensemble, but you're going to hear the band in a moment. But I'd like you to welcome to the stage Mr. Kendell Nielsen and the 2022 Honor Band. I love Wyoming. This is a cool place. I just want you to recognize how wonderful this group of people is up here. 2 days together. What is it, 14 schools or something like that? A lot of schools. And they're just making music together, and it's amazing. When Mr. French called me, and by the way, I would like to thank also, I know it's been thanked 100 times, but we're so lucky to be in this hall
with people like Dr. Paris and all the others from Northwest Community. Get them on. I don't know if you noticed that percussion ensemble, but if you were counting dollar signs, there was like $150,000 worth of stuff on that stage. So somebody's supporting music in this part of the world, and so I'm very, very impressed. Well, when Mr. French called me, I right away knew which tune I wanted to do. First of all, I trusted his musicianship, so I decided to trust your entire district's musicianship. I've chosen a tune called Russian Christmas Music, but it has nothing to do with Christmas. Actually, it's written by a gentleman by the name of Alfred Reed, who joined the Army when he was 20 years old in 1941 and performed with the Army Band for the 4 years of the war, 5 years of the war. After D-Day, the world wanted to celebrate those who were not part of the Axis. And so they decided to have a huge celebration and do all of this music. And because Russia was one of the countries that was working with the Allies, they asked, they wanted to do some Russian music so that when all of the leaders got together, every country was represented. And they were going to do some music by a gentleman by the name of Shostakovich, but they couldn't find him because he was stashed away in some isolation camp somewhere. So they had Alfred Reed in 18 days write this piece of music. This, my friends, is my honor to the veterans in this hall today. This piece was written for the armies, for the armed services. So if there's anybody in here that is a veteran, would you please stand up right now and accept the applause of this audience? This piece was not written for a high school band. This piece was performed by professionals in 1946. It was performed, it had its debut in the United States at the Juilliard School of Music. That's when they first heard this piece, Juilliard School of Music. And then it was performed by the Syracuse University Band, and Alfred Reed dedicated the tune to the director of the Syracuse Band. These people are playing music that's written for musicians, and they have shown me in 2 days that they're filled with music. Now it's going to take you through every emotion you can have. It goes through every emotion as possible, and I need to just introduce you to one instrument that's going to be featured. This is Micah from Cody High School. Micah plays an English horn. Would you hold up your English horn? French horns, would you stand up? Hold up your French horns. This is a French horn. The truth is, it was invented in England. This is an English horn, and all it is like a pregnant oboe. With the oboes, it's one of those, only bigger. The only thing it has in common with French horn is that they're both in the key of F. So that's what it is. But this piece is going to feature this gentleman, and boy, was I so glad to find him, because when you hear the piece, you'll understand why. But he is such a fantastic musician, and it's really, really cool. Now, I could like have everybody stand up like the choir did, but we'll take too much time on that. Just know that I'm in love with every one of these people in a good way. And that now it's a 13-minute piece, and it's going to take you through all of the emotions that you can possibly have. That amazing percussion section you just heard is going to fill up the hall again. So I give you now Alfred Reed's Russian Christmas Music. Thank you. that's about as much emotion as any audience can stand. So we're gonna end with something that just make you go tapping your toes out. This is called, I love the name of this tune, Blues for a Killed Cat. By a gentleman by the name of Jack End. We're featuring Henry on the drum set back there. Is that right, Henry?
Yep.
And we're featuring as soloists, see if I can get this, Aiden. Stand up. What's your last name, Aiden? Where are you from?
Thermopolis.
Thermopolis, Aiden. And Ivan. This is Ivan. What's your last name, Ivan? Thomas from? Where? Whirling. These two gentlemen are going to put their souls on the line during the middle of this piece. You'll love it. Make sure your mics are on when you do it. Thank you. young people. They wouldn't be here without you. So I would like you to give them a hand right now. And to these amazing band directors, I'm going to come here often just so I can learn how to grow a beard. That's so cool. That was like 5-6 band directors that make me look like I don't even know how to do it. Okay. Anyway, I love Wyoming. I love your folks. Keep them in music. There's a plaque out in the middle of this thing, and I'm going to oh, by the way, Dr. Ferris, thank you for the baton. It's magic. Thanks. There's a plaque out there you got to read by Plato. And he said, if I have children, if I'm teaching children, I'm going to teach them physics, philosophy, and music. But mostly music, because the keys of all learning are found in the patterns of music. Right, Tyler? Okay. Thanks. Have a great day.